Okay. So I'll start off the discussion with one most important aspect. Okay. So that is knowledge versus skill. Okay. So that is very, you know, it is a dilemma basically. What is deciding factor with respect to getting into service? Well, is it that knowledge is playing a major role, or you're equipped with all kind of intelligent innovation kind of things, or some people are in, you know, there are research scholars. And these people write great answers. They're not great answers, they write great content, in fact. Okay? And these research scholars, etc., all of them, are they in UPSC? So the one word answer for that is a simple no. Then why is it that they have so much of knowledge, okay, and still they are not in UPSC? Or why are they rejected? Okay, is there any specific reason for that? Okay, so this debate versus knowledge versus skill, I put it in my ad also, it is just not knowledge alone. And I said it is writing practice that matters. So I just wanted to explain the term knowledge here. So why did I call that knowledge, knowledge here? Knowledge is not sufficient. I'm not saying knowledge is not sufficient. Knowledge beyond a particular level does not play any role in the exam. That is what I want to convey. So that means limited knowledge. That means everybody reads all these books, and most of the books which we read are almost similar. Most of the coaching which we take is also almost similar, okay? And but still, most of the paper which we read, for example, most of us read one Hindu newspaper mainly. So everything is similar. Then why is it that only few are making? And those people who are making it on the service, are they research scholars from JNU? Or are they PhD candidates? Or are they only IITs, IIMs, etc.? Or is it that there is something else that has pushed them into service? Okay, so that is what is this debate talking about, knowledge versus answer. Knowledge versus skill, okay? Now here, what is a good answer? Then what is a good answer? Is it intellectually stimulating answers? There are some intellectually stimulating answers. They write great ideas, innovative ideas, which will be out of the box. Especially I'm talking about the polity paper. Okay, that is, I'm talking about the paper two, okay, where we have polity, where we have IR. Okay, that particular paper where the average score is somewhere around 65, 70, 75. And if we push ourselves maximum, we will get somewhere around 80, 85. Even the toppers are landing up with a score of 85 or 80 max, or at most they can push it to 90. This is the situation. Okay, then why is that why is it happening? Is it that we have not read Indian Constitution well? Or is it that we have not read Hindu issues, or we have not mugged up current affairs properly? Okay, I don't think that is the reason. So what I felt was, what is a good answer? Good answer is nothing but a mark-fetching answer. If I write that answer, I should get marks. If I get marks, that is a good answer. It is not intellectually stimulating answer, okay? So, or it is not something like, no, you come up with a great idea, out-of-the-box thinking, okay? See, most of the time in polity paper, they come up with one aspect, in your opinion. So what is this, in your opinion? What I feel is, in your opinion does not mean is asking you an innovative solution. In your opinion is nothing but a popular opinion. Talking about innovative, like your opinion is popular opinion. What is a popular opinion? Popular opinion is there is some committee. There are some ARC reports are there. These committees have already done a lot of research, more than what we think. I'm not hitting your intellectual capacity. What I'm trying to tell you is already they have done a lot of research. There is a lot of material already in place. And these committees come up with a lot of recommendations. And in your opinion is not your opinion. It is committee's recommendations. Committee's recommendations or popular opinion. 12,000 students who are writing mains come up with their own opinions. There is no time for them to analyze. It is a routine activity for them. Okay, that is something which you'll understand. One more interesting fact here is, in one paper, suppose you take history is there, Indian society is there, geography is there, then is it that three people are going to correct one answer sheet? That is something which you should think of. No, three people are correcting one answer sheet, or is it one person who has some vague knowledge who is correcting all the three because he's been given a model answer? Because he's being given a model answer. Then what is this model answer? Model answer means objectivity. Model answer is nothing but objectivity. That means what? Question paper is subjective. Question paper is completely subjective. We say, no, GS is subjective. Whatever they ask, they may ask anything under the sun. But if at all there is a model answer, that means he is expecting objectivity or is expecting precision. Are you able to follow what I'm trying to tell you? So that means what? In this particular case, I am saying mark-fetching answer is not scholar's answers. Mark fetching answer is some recommendations, or ARC reports are there, several committees are there, several reports are there, etc. They have already done a lot of research, ethics, corruption, etc. ARC reports are there. Okay, so those recommendations, that will be my stand basically. That is what I want to make it very clear. Okay, now slowly one by one we will go. What UPSC expects is what the heading I have given there. Okay, so leaving is more important than reading, I have put, and of course it can hit some of your egos. Okay, I am also a person who have written some attempts, more than 4. So obviously we have also read more. Okay, the logic is very simple. Then if you have read so much, then why is it that you have not pushed yourself? Okay, so reading is, that means what what I want to explain here is it that reading too much? Today there is information overload. Simple logic. Information, everybody knows what is information overload. You open website, you have so many sites available. Insights, IAS Baba, Ramsudhir IAS Academy, RC Reddy, anything. But you open one click button, you have so many articles. What to read, what to leave is the question mark. If I don't read these articles, then I'm not going to make it to the exam or what? That is nothing but it is creating fear psychosis. Though you read all, you're not there in the service. Then what? Then it is a question mark. Understood? No. Okay, so that is something which we need to keep in mind. So leaving or reading intelligently. What is skill? Reading intelligently. So what are the skills which they are testing in UPSC mains and especially paper 2 I'm talking about, because that is a paper where generally, you know, when we conduct that 30 member batch after prelim, okay, where all these people have written 4 or 5 mains come to us, we tell them that don't give much focus on polity paper because anyhow you'll not get 100. But I'm not making that statement here. Okay, so since we have time, okay, better increase ethics scores and marginalize it so that you'll be through. Okay, a paper where you can't push marks, why is it that you're trying so much? Anyhow, you'll get 75 or 80 only. So that is something which we do. That is a strategy when 60 days before exam. 60 days before exam. Now it is something like we are almost like we have 1 year time for the next mains. So the target is the next mains, no? So we'll just try to analyze why. Okay, with respect to the second paper, okay, so especially second paper. So there you can see why this method of selection, I put what is skill here. I said skill is better than knowledge, no? I made this statement that skill is better than knowledge. I said organize, manage and write direction. Organizing, managing and reflecting your knowledge. Reflecting your knowledge. Reflecting in your knowledge in the given time. Reflecting your knowledge in the given time. It's not about you reading in a vast manner. Okay, ultimately writing whatever you feel like writing. Okay, and it is reflecting your knowledge because there are polity paper. Why is it difficult? It is difficult because this paper is seen in a different perspective. When we use the term Indian polity, everybody feels Indian polity is only Indian constitution. Indian polity is not just Indian constitution. There are other aspects to Indian polity. All the perspectives have to be addressed. I put the heading there, 360 degree perspective. So what is this 360 degree perspective? Simple logic here. What I want to talk about here is, so there is Indian constitution in place. There is a logic for placing a constitution. There is a logic behind placing a constitution. You wanted to run Indian society appropriately. That means there is an aspect of Indian society involved here. Okay. So Indian society has to be taken care of. Many a times they would have framed some policies which are not working after 1960, 1970. Okay. For example, one simple example, one person, one vote system, single vote system has led to something called as caste politics. Now, caste politics or caste is an aspect related to what? Indian society. Are you able to follow what I'm trying to tell you? Indian society. Or we have come up with something like 73rd and 74th constitutional amendment. Okay, so amendments are also there, no? So 73rd and 74th constitutional amendment, so we have given reservation to women. So is it that we have tried to address something called as the patriarchal mindset? Is it that we have come up with addressing the patriarchal mindset, okay, which was in part and parcel of our Indian society? So we started giving 33% reservation, no. But was it 100% successful? No. Though they are head, their husbands are going and doing everything else. So that means what? You have come up with an amendment, but that did not do any good as far as society is concerned. Are you able to follow what I'm trying to tell you? So that means Indian society as such plays a critical role when I'm thinking about Indian polity. Okay. So that means one is you frame the constitution. whatever is there in the constitution, is it taken as it is? Is it taken as it is? It is not taken as it is. It is taken as if it is in Supreme Court. Interpretations are very, very important and critical. Okay, for example, let it be Jallikattu ban. Okay, so, or let it be a Jainism Sallekhana. Okay, so basically, right to die, is it part of Article 21? No. It's about right to die. It need not include right to die. It is a religious fundamental. Which one? Sallekhana is a related to something related to religion. Something related to religion. As per IPC, committing suicide is a criminal offense. Okay, so it's a criminal offense. There are discussions about this, no? So now talking about an offense kind of thing here. So what I want to tell you is, that means what? Here there are two different aspects. One is religion. So when talking about a religious issue, Sallekhana, Article 25 to 28, talk about something called as religious freedom. Okay, and similarly, when you talk about Article 19.1 and 19.2, I'm talking about right to freedom, and I'm also talking about restrictions also. Are you following? So, is it that, so how did Supreme Court interpret Sallekhana? Okay, so it is something like going against the principles of constitution because there are already reasonable restrictions placed. Okay, and even expansions of Article 21 do not support right to die. Okay, then what was the Supreme Court judgment? It said, Supreme Court did not go according to the principles of constitution here in this particular case. What did Supreme Court do? Supreme Court said, okay, fine. Sallekhana, it is not an offense because it is related to religion. But you have to follow two major principles. Two major principles. You should not be glorifying or there should not be any publicity with respect to Sallekhana because you are doing it for spiritual upliftment. So what is spiritual upliftment? You should not be attached to anything. So though, why are you publicizing it? Okay, so you are publicizing it means something wrong. And one more thing is, Sallekhana, if such kind of decisions they have taken, okay, they should be given sufficient time for implementation. Suddenly emotion lo theesukochu oka decision. Okay, tarvata andaru em anukuntaro emo ani cheppi oddile anukochu. So kabatti koncham time iste probably his mind may change. Are you able to understand? So that was something like they came up with saying that, okay, give, then come with its implementation, okay, and you can't call it as completely, you know, going against the principles of constitution, okay, we'll interpret it in a different manner, but there should not be any pomp or publicity. So what is this? Is it completely related to what constitution is saying? No, it is something that is interpreted by Supreme Court. That means people ask this question, sir, in a 200 word question, or a 200 word answer or a 250 word answer, should we write cases? Should we write cases? This is something like every time we have this problem, like whether we should push cases because it is only 250 word. No, we should mention cases or we should not mention cases. Okay, so when Indian polity is not just about constitution and it also focuses on interpretations of constitution done by the Supreme Court, then what is the mistake in writing one or two cases which are relevant? Are you able to follow? Okay, so I don't say everything is 100%. Whatever analysis we are trying to do is 100% okay. No, there is a logic behind it. If you see some of the questions, like for example, the Diwali crackers question was there. An environmental effect on because of Diwali. Okay, and he also asked in that particular question, briefly mentioned the Supreme Court cases related to it. Probably what is he talking about? He's talking about a complete question where he's trying to include each and every aspect. That is the legality aspect, the constitutionality aspect, and the constitutionality aspect interpreted as far as Supreme Court cases are concerned. Hope you're able to follow. I'm not saying you'll remember all the cases possible, no. But whenever a famous thing happens, whenever we're reading some current affairs, one or two cases which are famous in our mind, and we'll push it whenever there is a question coming on that. Are you able to follow? Okay, so that is something which, okay, I am talking about, like, we related to that is Indian constitution alone. Okay, you can't call it as something like Indian polity. So Supreme Court perspective also has to be taken into consideration along with that Indian society. Okay, so what is the difference between a question that is falling in paper one and falling in paper two? If I'm going to address only the societal issues of a problem, So at times when we see this answers, no, you find that if there is a question related to women, etc., etc., okay, that too in paper too, or talking about the polity paper, you start up with writing all the 4 points or 5 points from Indian society. Mari Indian society paper one lo kuda undi kada, mari paper one ki paper two ki there should be some difference. Then what is the difference? Then some constitutional element which we are showing, that is the difference. Some keywords related to constitution we are showing, that is the difference. Are you able to follow? So, and at times we find WTO question, we find WTO question in paper 3, that is I'm talking about the economy part, or you will find WTO question in paper 2. Then in paper 2, then is there any difference then? Why you can push it in paper 3, no? If it is coming in paper 2, there is something else which is expecting. And that expectation may be related to constitution, may be related to Supreme Court judgment, may be related to some policies framed by government. Policies are there now, or committees. Why there are policies and committees? See, everything is included in the constitution. Everything in the sense like, if there are policies or committees which you are launching, there would be an interlinking aspect in the constitution. Okay, for example, when we talk about Swachh Bharat, okay, and when I also talk about manual scavengers, Swachh Bharat, building toilets, manual scavenging. Manual scavenging, there is Indian society perspective. What is the Indian society perspective there? Caste-based discrimination. Caste. Are you following? Okay. Is there an act there? Acts and policies are there? No. So manual scavenging in place. So that means though there is something like already provisions there in the constitution, then why is that you have acts? You have acts means, that means what? Acts are there so that if there is an anomaly in the constitution or the constitution is not in line with the current trends, you will come up with amendments, and policies are all everything so that you run the society appropriately, and therefore acts also, additional acts which are there, which are already placed. For example, when I'm talking about manual scavenging, there is act in place. Okay. And similarly, there is untouchability article. Which article? Article 17 in place. Okay. So there's article 21 involved. That is, I'm talking about constitution. Right to life talks about right to dignified life. So article 21, article 17, act is also there. If at all there is a Supreme Court interpretation, then that is also has to be taken into consideration. Ante question polity 360 degree ante constitution. Okay. Supreme Court interpretation of the constitution. Okay. Indian society impact, not completely about Indian society, but Indian society also has to be taken, because constitution enduku, the reason is society. Okay, and policies and committees and additional acts, bills already placed. So I'm not saying in every question all these would be integrated, only then my answer will come. While teaching it is easy, I know the difficulty. When you're writing all this, you will integrate and write, no, but it's at least three. So when I see the question paper, I will think in that manner. From Indian constitution. When I'm reading current affairs, I will link my current affairs to Indian constitution. It's one of the simplest example, Arunachal Pradesh presidential election. Okay, so same thing I've pushed it. Okay, Indian constitution goals not achieved. Okay, so society has to be taken care of. The aspects you will take, Supreme Court interpretation, Indian constitutional amendments. Important thing is, we have read all the newspapers, then why is it that we are not getting marks in polity? See, I'm not saying polity will hit 130 like ethics. Remember again, 130 avasaram ledu, 5 markulu verithe jal jeevithalu maaripothayi. It's all about 5 marks, it's all about 1 mark, it's about half mark for each question. The fight is only for half mark for each question. Half mark for each question, I'm writing 17 questions. I have to get 8.5 marks in each paper. You are in or you are out. So simple logic is that for all this fight is only for that half additional mark. I'll talk about this when I'm talking about keywords. I'll talk evaluate, etc. Okay, so this fight is only for that half mark. So 360 degree perspective, I'm not saying again beat round the bush. No, beating round the bush, no. It's, the question is related to constitution. You're saying you have to address all this. No, look at polity question or a governance question from a 360 degree perspective. Indian polity ante idanta. And for, anyhow, in the exam, all interlinking with respect to all these, we definitely can't do. So what we will do, one or two aspects, we will try to do. Understood, no? So that is one thing which I wanted to, like, polity mein why so less marks? Okay, 60, 65, 70. Entha kashtapadna 65, 70. Sir, flow chart lesam. Next time, ele kunda try jala. Okay, so I think you are able to follow what. So we will try this. We'll try this method. When you're reading current affairs, try. So whenever there is a current affair, directly hit to the constitution. It will be there. There will be a place for a polity current affair in the constitution. If it is not there, it will be there in the amendment. If it is not there, it will be there basically in some policies and frameworks which the government has come up with. Is that okay? Okay. And one more important thing which I wanted to talk about is your opinion. In your opinion, polity paper law, intellectual capacity or your out of the box thinking will help you in ethics paper. I do agree. Because you'll come up with novel solutions. And that you have to come up in that limited time span. Okay, but in polity, popular opinion ante, already there is hell a lot of information that is already there, documented. So why do we want to come up with our own solution and expect that our solution will be better than 12,000 students who are writing? He will not be ready enough. So people who are correcting, no, they will not be, they will not expect so much of innovation. And the innovation expect jeste, vere laga undal exam. Are you able to follow? So that means it's not about innovation. It is about a regular formalized answer. What is a regular formalized answer? There should be objectivity. Why there should be objectivity? Because precision, okay, will come with objectivity. Objectivity should be there because though it is a subjective paper, there may be a model answer in hand. And model answer will say something. And he will go in accordance with the model answer. If 10 points are there in the model answer, man there at least 5 anipistunai, okay, he will be satisfied. Manam inni samacharalan chadutunte, we don't have complete grip by the time of the 5th or the 6th attempt. Do you think the person who is in university, who has n number of problems, will have complete grip on whatever question we are writing? I 100% doubt. That is 100% doubt, no? 100% it is 100% I'm sure. Okay, that he will not have complete knowledge about in and out. He will not read paper regularly and he will say, oh, this is something related to this question. But he will find, oh, this fellow is updated probably. It is all probably. Then how do we make our answer objective? That means you have to make your answer formal. What is formal? Whatever is recommended somewhere or documented by popular people, that is formal answer. Aha, vidu cheppindi ekkada inna. Lepothe, it is there in the model. Are you able to follow? I've written very good. Then why is it that we have got less marks? Then there may be some key. Okay. So that is the thing. And one more thing. One more important aspect. Is it that three people are correcting our sheet? Suppose economy is there. Is economist correcting our sheet? And there is something like we have also have internal security part. Okay. Is somebody else? Disaster management. For disaster management, do you think one more specialized person? First of all, people in university who are into research, no, they will feel correcting UPSC papers is a menial job because they create knowledge. They create knowledge, they do research, they create knowledge. We vomit knowledge in the exam. So why should we correct something like that? It is not innovative. They have crapped something or writing whatever they feel like. So generally what happens is somebody who is working on a temporary basis in universities, contract basis in universities will also be correcting the papers. I am not doubting the capabilities of contract basis. No. Is that okay? I think you are able to follow. Okay, so that aspect I want you all to keep in mind. So popular opinion means committees or commission's recommendation. This is what I have mentioned here. You can see. Okay. Own thought versus popular opinion. So I am not doubting your intellectual capacity. I am not doubting, you may be innovative, extraordinary. Okay, so, but still, this is a better route. Specific answer, or I am talking about objectivity, or creativity is subjective. You show me any creative person, baahubali baahundi creative gundan jepte, I will say this, that is copied. So there is nothing like something like people keep saying no. And creativity ni encourage chestara an answer sheet lo vadaku avasaram ledhu. Ardhamaindi anukunta. So that is like this is something like which I have talked about. So you talk about movie ban, you talk about Jallikattu, or you talk about Sallekana, you talk about anything that is coming in news, etc. It can be interlinked to Indian Constitution, or it can be interlinked to interpretations of Supreme Courts. Okay, so interlinking. So the crux point is interlinking. That is what I wanted to mention there. Okay, so interlink all those aspects. Then it is our policy answer. At least one or two aspects. We are better than other person. Okay. Should we mention cases? Many a times this is the tension. Okay, 200 word question. Lo cases ela mention chestamu. How can we mention cases in such a small answer? And first of all, we'll not. Okay, and second thing is, can we mention? Yes. I say because Supreme Court interpretations are important. And therefore, one or two cases, will not fill the paper with cases. Will not fill the paper with cases. Are you following? Okay, so that is something which, so I'm talking about presidential elections, etc. I'm talking about something like Article 356, interpretations, etc. There are some famous cases. So if we know those cases, we will push them in the exam. Nothing wrong. That is the second area. That is Supreme Court area. Indian Constitution, Supreme Court interpretation area. In that Supreme Court interpretation area, comes these cases. If they are very, very important, one or two, if we remember, we'll push them. Understood? No. So if there's a conflict between fundamental rights and directive principles, in the prelim Lakshmikant book itself, we read number of cases. Okay, so we'll try to push those cases wherever possible. And if we find it is apt and relevant. Okay, so cases rayaddu. Raste marks raavu anedi wrong. Limited cases, one or two, to support my answer, talking about Supreme Court, etc., is good. Nothing wrong. Okay, so but no publicity, no, not immediately Supreme Court judgment. For spiritual upliftment, okay. Okay, so I'm talking about that Sallekana only. Okay, so spiritual upliftment, good. Okay, but sufficient time. Did Constitution talk about it? No. Protection against, you know, environment, etc. Okay, protecting environment, etc. Was it part of Indian Constitution? Okay. Then what about religious freedom from 25 to 28 when it comes to Deepavali, cracker? There is something called as religious freedom, no? Okay, and there are, Then under such circumstances, of course, directly government, you know, you can't say, unless, you know, Delhi situation is different. Okay, now you say, over-interference of Supreme Court. Who is talking about that? Then Supreme Court comes and says, no, then what will government do? Government comes up with what? Awareness policies. No cracker, that means crackers are not compulsory for Diwali celebration. You come up with all kind of awareness policies, etc., no? So all that awareness policies, etc., which you're trying to do, that would be the last part of the question for Diwali. Are you able to follow? So that is something like, what is government trying to do in such a case when there is some conflict involved? So then government is coming with you know, there are a lot of things, no? There are radio jockey, etc. There's a lot of publicity, no? Don't burn crackers, etc. Spoil your environment. Even there are school campaigns, etc. done, okay? Enlightening kids that your environment is getting spoiled. So you can't push something directly, and therefore awareness campaign. So this would be the last part of the discussion when I'm talking about that Diwali, etc. Are you following? So please, I will talk about one. I'll make a statement here. I'll say read less and think more. I made this statement when people came, discuss and all. So probably when we take our mains question papers, okay, so we can sit with those question papers and see what we should have written and what we have written. Okay, and we say that everything I've written well and still have not got marks, especially ethics paper. Some people land up with 60 marks, 55 marks. And what are the books they read generally? They read books related to US ethics. Corporate ethics, okay, and you read so much, okay, and you write something which is illogical and impractical. I'm telling you very frankly, there are people who have got 120, who have got 130 in ethics. Ethics is a very scoring paper, okay. So what would be the strategy for ethics? Two strategies. One is you should have a clean heart, which is the most difficult thing, which we'll not have, obviously. Okay, so clean heart is not possible. Then second thing is, you should look clean. You will practice in such a manner that your solutions will look so very clean, okay, and apparent that this fellow has not bluffed. Okay, how will we do it? I'll show you. I'll show you with an example. Okay, so we'll do that with an example. Okay, so this is all about what we have discussed with respect to polity. Okay. So moral of the story, I said connection. So three teachers correcting one paper, doubtful. Okay, so all that we have written. So this was the question actually. Does the right to clean environment entail legal regulations on burning crackers during Diwali? Discuss in the light of Article 21 of Indian Constitution and judgment of Supreme Court. Court undi, Constitution undi, legal regulation undi. Society getting affected and environment protection, all are there. This question, I felt like this question is very apt to look at polity question in a 360 degree angle. Okay, so 360 degree angle means all those which we have thought, no? So they are visible. He has directly asked all those. Okay, so. So there were cases like Subhas Datta versus Union of India or MC Mehta case, which is a long back. Okay, so 1990s. Okay, so these are some cases. Of course, in the exam, are we going to remember them? Definitely not. Definitely not. Kakapothe oka idea undi. Oho, cases rayachu. So somehow if you have read it during the current affairs and Diwali gurinchi vachinappu newspaper lo, somewhere they would have referred this case. So generally we say, oh, cases, what to remember, we'll leave it. No, okay, one case I will remember which is recent. So that I will push it wherever possible. Okay. Okay, one more small example. Okay, so that is about, you know, why polity. Of course, I don't say, it's all about practice. It's all about practice. And looking at an answer in 360 degree, all that is practice only, which we will do. But here, I'll just want to show you an example here. Now, suppose there is a question called globalization and inclusive growth. Or there was also an essay, does capitalism bring in inclusive growth? I believe it's 2015, I think. Okay, so now, how should I look? This is an economy question now. It has come up in economy, suppose, Indian economy part. That is in paper 3. Okay, so I'll talk about flowcharts later, whether we should draw, why we should draw, why we should not draw, all that. But globalization, inclusive growth. Now, is there any Indian society aspect involved in this particular question? Is there any society related impact? Or there is, in paper 1, you get questions like impact of globalization on women. Or feminization of agriculture. Idi na telusi Indian society part. This is Indian society. Isn't it? Indian society. Okay. Now I am asking you, like, this is not Indian society question, but this is an economy question. Globalization's impact on inclusive growth. Now in this question, what should be my perspective? I'm asking you. Like, inclusive growth means what according to you? Indian society, what is inclusive growth? You'll tell me. Okay. And on the other side, that is economics wise, what is inclusive growth? Okay, so based on which you'll tell me like what I should write, then I have a doubt now, what should be written? See, we say that 11th five-year plan, we came up with inclusive growth, etc. Okay, and we say inclusive growth means we take everybody in the process of economic growth, we'll not neglect the poor people, we'll focus on Indian economy, at the same time we'll come up with Janani Suraksha Yojana, okay, Kalyan Lakshmi programs, etc., etc. That means we'll also take care of welfare, India being a welfare state. Okay, so including everybody. Then who pushed globalization on India? Is there somebody pushed it or we wantedly accepted it? Pushed it forcefully, obligation, 1991. We were obligated to implement reforms. It's not that we were in a comfortable position. Okay, so therefore we have implemented. So there's something like from great crisis comes great change. Essay topic, no? So that was a crisis, 1991. Great crisis that we have come up with such a great change. Okay, in the form of LPG reforms, and that G there in LPG is globalization. Okay, so economics wise, yes, we have crossed Hindu rate of growth. That is less economic growth. Customers started having more and more choice. There is availability of options. More private sector and employment opportunities developed, okay, but skill-based, again, in question mark, in brackets, skill-based employment opportunities developed, okay, and Indian middle class benefited maximum, I'm not talking about the poor, Okay, and globalization will talk about an aspect called as market. Market, not government, but market. So government versus market, market prevails. So governance will focus on only regulatory aspects. It will not enter into economic fundamentals anymore. Okay, so all this. Then inclusive growth means we are coming up with programs, etc. Different programs. Okay, 1 rupee rice, subsidies are still there. All this is there. Now from the society perspective, Indian society perspective, if I have to talk about inclusive growth, what are the areas I will check when I'm talking about inclusive growth? Inclusiveness means who are the stakeholders in inclusiveness? Who are the stakeholders? One is vulnerable sections. Vulnerable, easily affected sections. SC, ST, disabled. Okay. Two, women. Women. Okay, that is why in society also you're getting such questions. The impact of globalization on society, on women. Okay. Children. Aged. Okay. This is which question? The aged also, there's a question already asked. Indian society. Okay. So when I'm reading globalization, I will not read globalization only for Indian economy. That is the mistake we do. Globalization, 1991. Okay, there was a problem. We didn't have Forex reserve ledu kabatti appu techukunnam. Okay, and later on we opened up our markets. We allowed agriculture products also. India suffered. All this economics. Free market moving towards capitalism. This is economics. Okay, but in Indian society, if I have to interlink then and there when you're reading about globalization, would be impact on aged, impact on women. Okay, if you see after globalization, child sex ratio, which was earlier doing well, did not do well. It reduced child sex ratio. When I'm talking about sex ratios, they say there was improvement in sex ratios, but child sex ratio, there was no improvement. Okay, is it that then you have sex ratios have increased because there were more women who are aged? Or is it that children, more kids who are born are girls? Those two things, if I observe, what is the observation there? Child sex ratio going down, regular sex ratio increasing. Means there is a problem. There is a problem there. That means the technology of ultrasound, etc., which was brought in, would have been misused after 1991, affecting Indian society. So what should be done? Put up trackers, push in trackers in ultrasound machines. I'm talking about solution kind of things. Are you able to follow? That means, did technology do everything good? No. Indian society perspective. Are you able to follow? See, first green revolution made Haryana and Punjab one of the richest states. Richest in the sense, at least with respect to farmers, have become very, very rich. That means these are agrarian economies. Agrarian economies are where women are least respected because there is an element of land involved. Okay. And you have Kap Panchayats operating where? Child sex ratios less where? Haryana. Is it that there is no money? No, because an aspect called as land. So women is better off in industrial society or agrarian society? Industrial society. Agrarian society, I'll link up Haryana and Punjab if I say. Because land is given more preference. Are you able to follow? So that means what? Looking at an aspect not from one dimension. Looking at an aspect from multiple directions. And so that I will not forget the topic, number one. And wherever the topic falls, what should I write? That is the next stage. Am I making sense? Okay, so that is something like, I'm not talking about economy here. So I'm talking about SC, ST, vulnerable sections, disabled, old age. There are acts placed. Again, that can be linked to polity. Disability Act is there. That can be linked to polity. So akkada society, act, constitution, paper 2. Okay, so when we're talking about Indian economy, as such, Indian economy is like something like only predefined questions he's asking. Okay, so labor, employment, unemployment, IVE questions. Okay, so you make all those areas, notes and all, it's simple. Understood, I think. Okay, and if I have to draw flowchart also, I'll come to that, not now. Okay, so when I'm talking about inclusive growth, I'm also talking about all the stakeholders here. Will my answer revolve completely about all the stakeholders in the economy paper? No. Economy paper lo mottam veela gurinche rasam, oka heading, women, vulnerable sections, disabled. Ante it is becoming Indian society answer. Mottam wrong adi. 5 marks, 4 marks vastayi 10 ki. 5 kuda raavu. Ardhamainda? So vachu, vachan raayalem kada. So it's an economy question. No, so economy question means economy jargon. That is called as keywords. Keywords. Very, very important is keywords. How will I say this is polity answer? How will I say ethics answer? I will prepare 100, 150 keywords. I will mug up. And I will scatter them in my answers wherever possible. That is the best strategy, I'm telling you. I'll learn all the subjects. I'll get into depth of all the subjects and then I will write answers. No. Get the hold of keywords and scatter them into our answers so that that answer looks ethics. Not saying all the answer will be long and only keywords will be. And what are the things we underline? We also underline keywords only. Okay, so polity, society loste, keywords vere. Economy loste, keywords vere. So keywords will vary because it will show that that particular question is related to that subject. Okay. Okay, the basics, no much tension here. Okay, so basics low. Okay, I've written some points. Everybody talk about these points. I will also talk about these points. I'll talk in a different manner and see, in some places I will take stand. I'll take stand for subjective aspects also. I'm taking stand means I've done a lot of research before taking a stand. So that means if I say you can write in points, how do you know? Okay, how do you know? Obvious. I will write in big, you should not write in big paragraphs. Did UPSC tell you? So, I'm taking stand means, you please don't question any. And I've taken stand after talking to many people. In fact, like, okay, suppose we've talked to Kirti, who has got, she was my student in Chaitanya. Okay, I think she has got some rank 16. Okay, 16 or 14 or chinde. Then we have asked her, like, what was your strategy? Why is it that you've got such a good score and you've got that? Ante, em le sir, isari eppudu chala kashtapadi focused ga rasanu, isari chala silly ga rasam. Ante, edo rasam ante. Okay, and I put flowchart for every question, he said. Flowchart for every question. Okay, then we thought, oh, that means if you are putting flowcharts, you will get marks. That is assumption. If I attempt 20, now that will come last. That is a debate between quantity and quality. Very important. If I attempt 20, will I get more marks? Topper say no. In jesa, any attempt jesa. I have attempted all the questions. And therefore, I am in. You are in because of this or you are in because of something else. You only don't know. You would have worked so hard all these years that your knowledge has enhanced, your writing skills are enhanced, and you are able to push in good answers, but you also wrote some nonsense for 3-4 questions, you completed 20. And you feel that because you have written 20 you have got, and you tell that to a fresher. So what he will do, 7 minutes timer he will put for each question, 8 minutes timer he will put for each question, and though for the questions he knows also, he will write for 7.5 minutes, 8 minutes. For the question he has no knowledge also, 7.5 minutes, 8 minutes, which is wrong. Which is wrong. We have to identify in the 20, which are the questions which I know, which are the questions where I can add more value. And these are the questions I will write first. Chinnapudu kuda antega, chinnapudu exams lo kuda, ochina first rastam kada. Paper theesukoni 1, 2, 3, no. Wrong strategy. Okay, so if suppose there's something like 12 questions, you will know 70%. 4 questions, you will know 40%. 16. Okay, 1 or 2 questions you would have heard somewhere. Coilo case. Eppudo Coilo. Telustu, you will write. Your luck that polity teacher would have taught you in class that time. Oh, you have written. That doesn't mean you are great. It is that time you have listened to, your luck played a role. Coilo case came, you have written. Finish. Okay, so Coilo case, I'm putting it in like last three. 3 questions, you don't know what it is. Now, don't know what it is, in still I will write this, fill it up and come. I will say don't do it. I will say don't do it. Why I'm saying don't do it is, there's a logic behind that. First is you're writing all the good questions. and which you know. So if you have to write it in 9 minutes, I'll spend 9.5 to 10 minutes, suppose. 9.5. So I'll add 1 mark more quality or half mark more quality. How do we know that he is, that fellow is going to gauge quality perfectly? Doubt. How do I know that that fellow will gauge my quality perfectly? It is better if I scribble those three questions. If he's going to give me one mark for those three questions, I will at least get 3 marks on that in that paper. Dilemma. This is the dilemma, no? So this is the dilemma. What I feel is, unless there are few exceptions, like 20 questions, last 3 questions also, they know few. It is a matter of luck and their effort they have put in. That's an exception category. But generally, the situation is 3-4 questions, we will not know anything. Even in the 6th attempt also, you will not know anything, 3 questions, because that is GS paper. So what I feel is, 17 attempting 17 is a fantastic idea, provided initial questions you have written in 9.5 minutes and done justice. And the other questions also, you have structured them, organized them well. Okay, and you have a good job of 17 to 18 and 2 questions you have not written. So I don't think it will create much of a problem. There are people who have written 20 and still got 70 marks. Then, are you able to follow? Okay, so there is this debate. I do agree. Okay, so I'll come to that. Okay, so if I go ahead with this basics. Okay, so interesting aspect. First one, I put this only, handwriting. Should handwriting be extraordinary? Not required. Should handwriting be above average? Average. Average handwriting, where you can read. Okay, whatever is written, where the examiner can read whatever is written is sufficient. Okay, so suppose asal manam rasindi evvariki ardham kaadu, then there is a problem. Aksharalu kalisipotha untayi. Okay, so that is the problem is there. Okay, because we've left writing practice long back. So when that is the case, probably buy a handwriting book and start writing for 10 minutes every day. If that is the case, that is the situation, like my answer is not at all readable. Okay, then the solution is that, will handwriting decide my success? Definitely no. Mar andar handwriting baagunnal andar daipal. Teena dabi handwriting baagund kaavat ochindante no. Are you able to follow? So it's not that handwriting only because of which she is in service, no. Understood, no. So handwriting, yes, you have to work on it if it is very, very bad. Okay. Now, second thing which we come across in answer writing discussion, etc., is underlining. Whether underlining is good or bad. First, underlining is a good idea. Why? I will tell you. When I'm 50 scripts, my student will tell you. Who that student's capabilities. And still, I will not feel like reading the complete paper. Not feel like ante ma paper this. Okay, so there is a logic here. Okay. So you will not feel like correcting the complete paper. Why you will not feel like? Because same question, same answer again and again, same nonsense you have to read. You should require hell a lot of patience. And that too, I know that it is my institute, it should come up, and therefore I will look into points. For him, you are. It's immaterial for that fellow. When such a not think of a child's future of his time, and therefore I should be very cautious. No paper ki. Enno frustrations untai intlo. So make the answer visible by underlining the answers. Don't underline everything. Over underlining. Complete answer you will not underline. So you should know what to underline. That is very, very important. So one more important thing is underlining, important. But what to underline is more important. And I will say you should practice underlining keywords. A keywords ela undalante, avi vere with in that answer, that keywords which you have underlined should reflect so much that half mark more. This fellow is up. That takeoff moment, no, half mark. Okay, this fellow has done well. Okay, this fellow is updated. He's interlinking. Knowledge lake pe na, ardhanga wali. Ardhamein nan kunta. Okay, so that is something like very, very important. Okay, now I will talk about this, which is very important. Diagrams in exam, mains exam. some toppers who have got 16 rank set. We have drawn diagram for every question. So next year we also followed such strategy where we taught students only diagrams. Not only diagrams, along with answers, we taught them diagrams also. Okay, so that means what? We came up with one dabba approach. If you see it on our Facebook, you will feel like, oh, for everything there is some box and there are some arrows visible. No, we were trying to reduce the complexity of the answer. So what is the benefit of diagrams? See, one I have put C here. Value addition. Suppose I'll show you in the next question. What is this value addition? I want to tell something other than what is asked in the question. Generally, telling something other than asked in a question in answer is wrong. Why? Because you don't have time and you'll be beating around the bush. And you don't know the answer, therefore you're writing something. But here, though there is something like, you know the question and still you wanted to tell something other than what is asked, I will show it in the diagram. I know this. That is one value addition. It will make the answer more, narrative and, self-explanatory. Okay. Second is time saving. Many a times the best method of saving time is diagram, I'm telling you. So when, especially some papers, what happens is by the time of 14th question we write, there's almost like only 20 minutes left or 15 minutes left. What to do? Only solution is, at least I have to attempt 3 or 4 questions. Edo kod jayal, en jayal. I will represent it in a type of flow chart. I'll explain it briefly. At least I'll get 2-3 marks if my diagram is okay. That is one benefit of diagram. Diagram will save your time. If you're able to show a diagram properly, it will save our time, definitely, yes. Okay, third major benefit of diagram is, it will make things more simple, okay. And remember, whenever I'm drawing diagrams, complexity should reduce. And not complexity should increase. Okay, there are some IITians batch with us, IIM batch unde. Okay, so when they put flow charts, what are they doing is, one box will be there, here 8 or 9. That means what? You are writing answer, that means a page mottam diagram hai. But you are very intelligent, you interlinked everything, positive, negative, you've written so much. But that fellow is not intelligent to interpret your complex diagram. Complexity should be as less as possible. If a small kid is given the paper, he should also understand this is something related to this question. Remember this, diagram is only for reducing complexity, not for increasing complexity. Especially diagrams are helpful for geography. Okay, if at all, in optional, definitely geography, it is helpful. Okay, so that is something. Should we draw diagrams in history? Okay, in history, the better way would be timelines rather than diagram. You know what are timelines? Okay, so timeline would be a better method rather than diagrams. And still you want to draw a diagram, you should know why you are drawing the diagram. Understood, no? Governance and okadabba esi. You take it. One more box. You put government's good policies. Then here you write good governance. Adi kuda diagram e. Esna vallu unnaru. Are you able to follow government policy? Of diagrams. Do not focus on such kind of diagrams. Understood, I believe. That means what? You're trying to, I don't think they will give you marks for such a diagram. Just for the heck of drawing a diagram, you have drawn diagram. No, don't do it. Don't push diagrams just because you have to draw flowcharts. Because toppers have said, we have pushed diagrams, therefore we have got rank. No. Diagrams kind of content undundach. Are you able to follow? Okay, so that is something like I'm talking about diagrams. So here, and one more important thing here, if suppose there is this question. Kanipistunda? Is this visible? What is universal basic income? What are the benefits and drawbacks of universal income? This is the question. Is the answer. At times, diagram is explained in the answer, isn't it? But I will show it clearly, and in the middle, I have put what is universal basic income. That means I follow a standard pro forma, which you need not follow. My standard pro forma is something like I'll put positive. I made this mind that I'll put positive on one side, negative on one side, okay? And in the middle, aspects which are related to the topic, I'll push it above and below. For example, are you able to follow? So that is how I do it. So I have this model in mind because it will save time. Okay, so whenever anything comes up, I'll push the same model. But same model for 20 questions, I think it is a wrong idea. Same model for 20 questions is a wrong idea. There are something like you can put a flow chart. You can put a, what do you call, what pie chart. You can put a table. You can put a table. You can just write plain answers without diagram when you find that it is not required. Are you able to follow? So therefore, you try to bring in that variation across 20 questions. Hope you follow. Don't come up with a... This is my model, which I generally, I like boxes and I feel easy. Okay, so I push boxes like this. Now, I think you've got it. So here, if you see, universal basic income negative is there. So inflation I've put, other schemes invalid, fiscal deficit will increase, and less incentive to work. It's all synopsis kind, okay? On this side, I've put women empowerment, okay? And I've said unconditional transfer, okay? Poverty, to some extent, will decrease, and it supports market economics. Market economics, because they'll have money in hand, they'll buy whatever they want, government can reduce subsidy. Okay, so, and basic principles, anyhow, I generally put basic principles up and down. That is, one is universality, another is unconditionality. This is what is asked, diagram for what is asked. These are put in Facebook already, that is why I have taken them. Okay, so these are already, what the question is asking, that is the diagram. I am explaining the question in the form of diagram. This is one style, okay. Second style, you can see, bad loans and distressed assets are a major drag on Indian economy. What steps have been taken to solve the problem? If you see, the steps are these. Kanipistunda? Is it visible? Back benches? Okay? No? First see RBI's steps. Okay? Later you can see government. Is it visible now? Okay, RBI steps see. I have put some schemes. They're everywhere. Economic survey, it is there. Everywhere it is there. Okay, so these are what RBI has done. All five. It is there in survey. Okay. Now here, there is something which government has done. This is the answer basically. Surface Act, Indira Dhanush scheme, Joint Lenders Forum. Is it okay that I write my answer like this? No. No. No, in the sense like, whether I should write in paragraphs or points, that time I will tell you. Okay, so is it that only I'm mentioning them? When will I mention? Suppose the question says enumerate. There are different terms. See, in GS, the problem is we'll not have time to write, first of all. Okay, second is whatever is asking, that comment, discuss, critically analyze, enumerate, etc. Understanding them and putting in exam time is very difficult. That is one more thing we'll keep in mind. But is it that we will not follow them? No. At least in the mock test preparation, I think we should respect those words so that it will become habit and tomorrow we will try to make some sense in the exam. See, if there wouldn't have been any logic for critically analyze, then why some questions there is critically analyze and in other questions there is discuss? There should have been some logic for that, no. So UPSC would have had some logic in mind for putting discuss or maybe putting enumerate or critically analyze. Are you able to follow? Enumerate is basically number. Enumerate the fundamentals of a particular policy. What did the policy say? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Enumeration. I am talking about number. That is enumerate. Very straightforward. Hope you are able to follow. So enumerate. So when you enumerate is kind of thing, if that comes up. So if I am mentioning the schemes and leaving, it is okay. The question is not saying explain. The question is not saying analyze. The question is only saying enumerate. Are you able to follow? So when it is saying only enumerate, why is it that I am wasting time in explaining? So just mention those points. For example, there are some committees. There is some committee like Nachiket Mohr committee say came up with some recommendation. Okay, so enumerate if he is saying. Okay, or what is that? Companies Amendment Act. Okay, so what are the basic aspects of Companies Amendment Act? Enumerate means 1, 2, 3, 4. What it has said? It is something like a factual number question. Understood? Their detailed explanation, I don't think it is required. Got it. Okay, so this is something like enumerate kind short form I have written. See, okay, government, what did it do? Okay, and RBI, what did it do? I have just mentioned them. I did not explain anything. Okay, and now 10 marker questions have come up. If you see, now 10 marker questions are there, no? This means. So 10 marker questions are there means we need to be still more careful. Okay, so should we explain all these 10 points in a 10 marker? Is it possible? No. Are you able to follow? So we have to be a little careful with respect to how many marks are allotted and what are the keywords. Okay, I'll come to those keywords. But this discussion is basically to show you this diagram. Now, see the question. Bad loan and distressed assets are a major drag on Indian economy. That is the first part of the question. Okay, and what steps have been taken to solve the problem? This is the second part of the question. When I am structuring my answer, all the parts have to be completely visible. That means if there are three parts of the question should be addressed. Or it should look like as if you have addressed the three parts. Kalipesi mottam rayaddu paper lo unnattu. Hope you are able to follow. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. If you are writing that way, probably, though you have addressed, it is not visible to me. So if you leave a gap for everything you have addressed in a three-part question, if I divide it into three parts, then it makes sense. Oh, this fellow would have addressed each and everything. If he's not interested in reading also, if he'll, oh, this fellow would have addressed the third issue also because it started off from a new para. Started off from new para means this fellow would have addressed. You only know what you would have addressed. But he feels that you have addressed. So the 2 marks will not go. Hope you are able to get what I am trying to tell you. So that is something very, very important. Very important. If there are three parts of the question, that Deepavali cracker issue, no, environment, legal aspect is there. He said constitution and he also talked about Supreme Court. So there are three areas, suppose. Okay. So understood. Okay. So that is something. Now this diagram, why I am showing is, this diagram is not directly related to the question, indirectly related to the question. See, the second part of the question, I've shown it in a box. What steps? Okay, first part of the question, bad loans are a major drag on the Indian economy. So you can just start off at right, bad loans are a major drag, etc., etc. But I've shown what are stressed assets and why it is caused, which is beyond what question is asking. Question is not why bad loans. Unda, why akada? No. The question is not why bad loans, no. But the diagram is why bad loan, observe. Diagram is not what the question is asking. Question is not why bad loans. If the question would have been why bad loan, okay, if I am writing in accordance with the question, my diagram, then my diagram is 100% apt with respect to the question. But this diagram is not in line with the direct question, but the diagram will help me understand what is stressed assets. Because it is a technical term, and stressed assets ki causes ne rasan. Why bad loan? Stalling of project, or I've written something like market slowdown, or willful defaulters like Vijay Mallya, or over leveraging, or borrowing more, or infrastructure loan, or all these things, because of which there is stressed asset. I've explained why there are bad loans. Was it asked in the question? No. And therefore, that I will not write in answer. Though you are putting in diagram, it is okay. This should not be written in the answer, because that is not what is asking. Hope you are able to follow. Okay, that is not what he's asking. That is not the question. I have just explained more than what the question is asking, for which I have used a diagram. So flowchart, when we are drawing also, there should be a scientific logic when we are preparing. So if you have decided some vague topics, for example, you said financial inclusion, ethics, corporate governance, RTI, good governance, there are n number of diagrams available in books and also in Google images. I'll push some in our discussion. Okay. So that means I will have a broad framework for diagrams, which I will practice beforehand. I will have some 100 diagrams or I'll have some 60 diagrams on the wide areas. Wherever possible, I will use the same diagrams in the exam. I will not innovate in exam. I will not use my brain in exam, because this is not the exam. There's no time in the exam, basically. There's no time in the exam that I will create one stressed asset. No. So I'll have a brief financial inclusion. There is a diagram. RTI, there is a diagram. Jallikattu, if I want to push in, there is a diagram in mind. If there is a diagram in mind which is already structured, if that question comes up, I will push it. Then if you have to do it, it takes away your time. So some 70 to 80 diagrams, I think you should be practicing beforehand. Understood? And it is compulsory, I'm telling you. And you need not do a lot of research. And see, ARC is good. Huh? You will not read everything. Suppose I am from public administration optional. So for which we would have read it. Okay. So it's not that you will all will read all the ARCs. You will select some topics, no, wide areas before mains. Okay, there will be, suppose there are 95 areas. In these 95 areas, where ARCs will add value. So there I will check, get back to ARC, I will have my synopsis in place, which I will read again and again before going to exam. That would be my strategy. I will not keep ARC books in front of me and mug it up. You will not recollect also. Understood, no. So identifying broad areas, for those broad areas, diagrams. ARC also, if I want to add value, for those broad areas only, I will read. Is that clear? Okay. So got the difference between first and the second diagram. There is a difference. Okay. So this diagram, if you see, it is something like direct answer only. Okay. Direct answer. Answer in a diagram. Time I pain up in jayali. Idi. When there is no time in the exam, I'm left with only 15 minutes. I have to write 5 questions. What should I do? This. I will do. Okay. I have time. I want to make my answer better. Okay, deenvalla benefit undachu. This fellow is not addressed, but I will address everything in the answer. So no tension. But I'm showing something other than what is asked. But I'll show it in diagram, not in the answer. Understood? Okay, so now, so that is about diagram. So don't put diagram just for the sake of drawing. Okay, one more. I have written some, put a nonsense diagram, which I say, just for an example, I said this is. Problems in health and education, government has improved infrastructure, so human capital will increase. Okay, so human capital will increase. Bond the diagram ante, is it making sense? Koncham, kaakapothe avasaram ledu. That can be written in a point format nicely. Okay, for which one point you have put a diagram, you have drawn a diagram wasting time? No. One or two more points will give you half mark more. So don't keep in mind, I'll go and draw diagrams for every question. That is the moral. Okay, I'll draw a diagram for every question is a wrong strategy. Wrong strategy. Okay, I said I'll take stand, no. Okay, I said I'll take stand. So drawing diagram for every question, I feel I'll pushing diagram, I use the term pushing diagram for every question possible is wrong. We can't do. Are diagrams required? Yes. Ela, exam lo draw chestama? Ledu, munde. Okay, so if you draw, if you would have practiced some 100 diagrams, no? One is India map. India map definitely will be of help. Mineral resources, etc., geography, okay? So, or sugarcane, etc., shifting, etc., all that, oka map esesi akkadi nunchi ikkadiki vachindani chupiyachu. Tribal question is there. In anthropology also, you can show it through India map, show diagram, okay, push it. So India map is always helpful. India map kallu muskon ACC attundali. Pankostadi. Got it, I believe. So India map is something like one of the first important diagram which you should learn is that map only. India map complete AL sina panledu. Our areas can picture it este chalu. And you'll put star, star, star that you'll show. Okay, so no invention in exam. Okay. Don't show your creativity. Ethics, economy, citizen. You are, briefly, you will learn all the diagrams. Diagram should be simple. You may be a very intelligent boy, but still, okay, no. Huh? Learn India map, location of industries, tribal questions, compulsory, compulsory. Okay, 100% it will be of great help, so we should learn. Okay. Wait. So these two, for example. These are all there in Facebook. Okay. So you can look into them later. Now, spacing of paragraphs. When I was correcting these sheets, no, that for the mains batch after prelim. Okay. So there is a problem with respect to organizing sentences. One major dilemma is paras or points. I have pushed in there. See, paras or points. Whether to write introduction, whether not to write introduction. One more dilemma, okay. Whether there should be conclusion for every question, or is it that without conclusion also, is it okay? These are some things which keep coming in the mind, okay? Whether introduction compulsory, okay? Whether conclusion compulsory. Body, when we are talking of whether it should be only points or whether it should be a mix of both paras and points. If at all paragraphs you are writing, whether the para should be big or small. Okay, so before I start that, I said no, you have to differentiate between one para and other para. Okay, so newspaper article ga laga raaste kalipi chadavalsi vastadi. Hope it is very clear. So there is a difference between GS paper and SA paper. In SA paper, I will avoid points. In SA paper, I will avoid diagrams to a maximum extent. Diagrams to a maximum extent. I will not draw flowcharts. I will not draw flowcharts. I will make my answer very simple in GS. There also, I will try to maintain simplicity. But if at all here and there, I want to show some flowery language, I can show in SA. Why paragraphs in SA? Because I have to show clarity of thought and the interlink between one para to another. Initially, there are two different ways of writing essays, which we'll discuss later. But one observation is, there are some people who cannot bring in connectivity between first para and second para and third para. So the best alternative is writing side headings. Even in SA, writing side headings in SA. Is it 100% the best strategy? No. The next step would be removing side headings and connectivity with respect to SA. So when I'm talking and SA, there is difference. So point format in SA, no. Point format in GS, okay. So GS can be a mix of both small paras and points. GS paper can be a mix of both small paras and points. Okay. If you're writing only points, is it completely wrong? Definitely not. Question on enumerate. Then think about writing paras and paras. But my point should not be something like shortcut point. Okay, for example, for shortcut point is what? Banks nationalization, 1969. Point type in. Okay, okay. Or you talk about some international relations, etc. You talk about civil war, Syria. Okay, so or these are some, there are like you, lack of time will push you. But is it right means wrong? Because the papers are not engineers. People who are correcting papers are not engineers. They are from the social science background and or an arts background. They expect some kind of introduction and a conclusion on a general note. Is it that introduction should be 100% there always? That is again, I'll talk about it later. But somebody is from arts background, social science background, etc. They want to see an answer, not like an engineering maths problem. And therefore, we will not write small points. We will write small paras and we'll also write points. Big para, 100% you should not write. Big paragraphs, 100% you should not write because you will not be interested in reading so much. Points etukkali. Getting it right. So small paragraphs and points, but not completely very small points. Placing of paragraphs is also to some extent okay and important. Okay. So don't like spacing of paragraphs and all. All parts of the question to be addressed. Okay. See, actually, points bring in objective. Brought in through points. So that means 1, 2, 3 means it's bringing in objectivity. You know the answer. Therefore, you are writing in points. But at the same time, you will add on paragraphs, smaller paragraphs to your points. So objectivity is seen because there is a model paper in hand. Therefore, I can write points is my logic. Are you able to follow? So, though the question paper is subjective, correction is objective, model answer is given, and therefore objectivity prevails. When objectivity prevails, points should prevail. And so points. Hope it is clear. So, just like that, I have not made statement. I would have analyzed it before making a statement, write in points. Okay, so, idi inko fantastic idi. Grammar. Okay, grammar should be good. Telugu medium, any medium, students also, grammar should be good. Essay, if your grammar is bad, definitely you will not get marks. In GS, if it is okay, okay. See, you can manage. Grammar can be, this exam is all about management only. We'll have all weaknesses. Those weaknesses should not be visible. Are we ethical if we get 140 in ethics? Definitely not. You are able to display ethics in such a manner that we have got 140. It is more fantastic. Understood? No. So that logic is something like 140 vachinodiki, 70 vachinodiki. 140 is more ethical than cheppalem. Understood? No. So the logic, but he has that logic. He has come up with. I'll talk about ethics later. Okay, so grammar, if there is a problem, I am just like, if Telugu medium students are there, or half Telugu, half English. This is the maximum batch. Ante at Telugu sarigga raadu, English good raadu. Okay, and but still there is a problem with respect to grammar, means essay you will suffer. So you have to improve your grammar. What you will do, it is up to you. If you come to me, we will see what we can do. Like in the sense like Renin Martin, Avi Jadwala ante anta avasaram ledu. Kaakapothe sentence raaste prati paragraph lo grammar mistakes lekunda unte chalu. Kaani essay ki matuku grammar mistakes undakoodadu. And those people who are good in Telugu and they find that their Telugu flair is very good, then write in Telugu also. Nothing wrong. And they feel that English is very, very bad. Their English is so very bad that they can't write. And they feel that they are from Telugu optional and their Telugu is very nice. Write it. There are people who have made it. So that call you only can take. I can't suggest. It's not beyond my this thing. I don't know your capacities. No. Okay. So, Adi. So, how many questions should I attempt? I explained, that only I have pushed in. Quality or quantity, time management in exam. Okay, so very, very important. Very, very important, okay. So my suggestion is 17 to 18, decent enough. Just because you have to attempt 20, don't overdo or reduce. Okay, fine. Hope it is, you're able to understand what I'm trying to tell you, okay. Now, keywords. What are these keywords? Okay, now we will see. How many questions that is over? No, keywords, okay. So keywords, see here. Many toppers, or we also, when we write, when we've written this mains exam, in GS you will not have time, and therefore thinking about the question and the keyword is definitely difficult. You can't think, okay, enumerate annadu, kabatti, I'll frame my answer in such a manner. But that will happen only through practice. That will happen only through practice. At least for few things, I will bring that justification. In mock tests itself, I've inculcated that habit. No, if it is evaluate, I'm thinking in this manner. If it is discuss, I'm thinking in this manner. Okay, fine. So now here, I'll start with this not easy, but a little tricky one. Okay, which is called as discuss. Okay, now what is your feeling if there is a question on discuss? Adi juice cheppa. Discuss is kind of debate. Okay.
Negative and positive.
Huh? And then come to a conclusion. Okay, fine. See, when two people are discussing, what they do is what is something like discuss. Okay, so you talk for, you talk against, or positive, you talk also negative. But in discuss, if it is there, conclusion becomes compulsory, and there should be a suitable conclusion. You said there are some positives. You have said there are some negatives. You have talked something about in favor of. You have talked something against it. Then what is a suitable conclusion? And always remember, my conclusion should be optimistic in nature. I will not be critical. In the sense like, again I'm making, I can criticize, but I'll not be critical about the policies. For example, something that is enshrined in the constitution or in the preamble itself, I criticize. Are you able to follow? India shouldn't have been a secular country. There is no socialism in India. This is, that means what, bedrock principles ne criticize jastram. So you can come up with criticism, but your criticism should be constructive. You will not criticize the core system because you are going to be a bureaucrat. Are you able to follow? Socialism. Preamble unte enti. There are some people, no, they get emotional and they write whatever they feel like writing and they hit the core principles. Core principles never you should touch. Understood. So you can criticize, but that criticism should be constructive. So in discuss, so I have written arguments in favor, arguments against, okay? And you will come up with a suitable conclusion. Suitable conclusion. So conclusion, so there is something like whether we should write conclusion or not. Okay, so when there it is saying discussion, okay, for social sciences expected is there should be a conclusion. Discuss jesi majjilo odilelem kada. There are two parties who are discussing two things. You can't leave it in middle, no, just like that. We have discussed. No, what is the crux of what you have discussed then? That should be concluded. And therefore I will write conclusion. Discuss. Hope you are able to understand. Okay, so for a discuss, yes. And Mari, in that, will I take arguments in favor more to conclude or arguments against I will conclude? Which one I will take? Ago Buddha. So Buddha's middle path. Okay, so basically I will not take complete stand. Okay, see, there are some questions. Do you agree? That is also a keyword. Nowadays you find, no, do you agree? Do you agree? Anagane, you should not start, yes, I agree. No, I don't agree. And you will write, no. That is a wrong format of writing. Do you agree? Ante, adi verbal discussion gaadu. That's not a verbal discussion. No, what is verbal discussion? Do you agree? No. No, I don't agree. Why I don't agree? Because that is my answer. Wrong. This, you are writing something, no? So, you should write your answer in such a manner that you will say, yes, I agree. By the time I conclude, no, by the time I reach the end paragraph, your answer should be hitting, yes, I agree. So, your yes, I agree will not be the first point. It will be something like your conclusion part will take you to that statement like, yes, I agree. Got the difference, no? So, do you agree? Yes. No. That is not the way. You come up with a policy in such a manner, you frame your answer in such a manner, yes, it shows that you agree. Then in the concluding part, yes, you can push something. You are not going to see. Yeah, you don't have time to read the entire question. No, what you say is right. See, what you say is, you want to show the examiner, this my answer will be in this format. Okay, and therefore, since there is no time, I'll say, yes, I agree. No, in the second paragraph itself, you can show your inclination towards what you agree. I'm not saying, don't show it in the first paragraph itself. In the second paragraph, okay, so balancing the aspects, we feel that probably this particular aspect is more inclined, and then you start supporting that point. But don't start your answer, I'm saying, by saying, yes, I agree. In the introduction, I will not write yes or no. Okay, let's discuss with respect to some example. Let's discuss it with respect to some example. So, is there any example in mind? Yeah, we will see people. Triple talak. Okay. Supreme Court has given. So, bring it that Supreme Court has said no. Supreme Court has given. So, say Supreme Court has given no. That is fine. Yeah, that is fine. As Supreme Court has come up with this, that is fine. Yes, I agree. And what are you to agree? Who are you to agree? Got it right. You're not a bureaucrat still. You're writing the exam. No, yes, I agree. And what? Emo, ela diskuntado. Egoistic fellow will take it in a different manner. Yes, I agree. And you start writing and the response changes. Okay, so is that okay? So, and practicality. Okay, no, where are we? Discuss. Okay. Now, one more word which is important is examine. Okay, examine. Now, basically, see, examine and one more term is evaluate there. You come across both of them. Now, when you compare discuss and examine, is there any difference? What do you think would be the difference? For example, NRAGS is a successful scheme launched by government. Examine. Means what? I will look into that particular question from very close fact, very close. Very close means what? How will I look into it very closely? I need some facts and figures. I need some facts and figures. If you have to examine a topic, you can examine a topic provided you have sufficient data. Sufficient data. For example, MGNREGS, though implemented, there was corruption, so it did not reach the beneficiary. Or because of which there was huge amount of rural inflation. So I'll show that rural inflation has increased by so much percentage. So what am I trying to do? I am observing the topic or I am seeing the topic from very, very close quarters. In discuss, facts and figures may not be that useful, but in exam, to analyze the topic by seeing the topic from very close quarters, because I have to examine the topic. I cannot examine MGNREGS unless I don't know what has happened because of MGNREGS. Suppose there is examine with respect to Right to Information Act, etc. So I need some statistics, I need some facts, I need some figures. See, there is a difference between discuss and examine. Okay, so you're writing positives, you're writing negatives, you're writing a conclusion in discuss. Okay, in examine, I will push in some facts and figures to say that that MGNREGS was okay, not okay, etc. So that means here I want facts and figures to see, and here I will examine each and every aspect. Why? Because I'm looking at it from very close quarters. And inflation is okay aspect. Corruption is another aspect in MGNREGS. Are you following? So MGNREGS has caused problems to agriculture because agriculture laborers are not available. And that for which I, if I have some facts and figures, it will suffice. It will suffice my answer better. Okay. My facts and figures. Gurtoste examine lagunta answer. Gurtu raakapothe adi discuss ayipothadu ante. See, you but have a pro forma in mind. No, examine means from close quarters. If we have that in mind, some point or the other will help us in examining it. You will try to examine it. See, examine and evaluate are almost same. Almost same with some changes. For evaluating an aspect, what is evaluation? Evaluation means you should say whether it is good or bad. Okay, so evaluation ante ante kada, idi baagundi idi baaledu. You submit your answers, I'll say, oh, this answer is right, this answer is bad. Okay, this answer is good. Why it is good, why it is bad, also I should write. Evaluate just odilelem kada. So in evaluation, the English word evaluate itself means please evaluate. Feedback or way forward is something that is become very important when I'm saying evaluate. No doubt, for which you require facts, figures, etc. Is there any difference? I have to conclude on each and every, whether it is good, bad, etc. I will not just leave, I will not just examine and leave it. I will talk about whether it is good, whether it is bad. Evaluation needs a feedback. So, when I have to write something way forward, you know what is way forward, conclusion tarvata kuda rayachu. After conclusion also, way forward if you want, you can push in. Okay, or I have evaluated it, I will conclude it, whether it is good, whether it is bad. That means positive, negative, good, bad would be my conclusion in evaluation. Are you able to follow? So there is some difference. See, then discuss ki no, examine ki difference enti ante, looking close, facts and figures, I said. Discuss ki, examine ki difference enti ante, I require more facts and figures where, when I'm talking about, when we are focusing on examine. Okay, and when examine and evaluate are almost same, examine and evaluate are almost same, then what is the difference? After evaluation, you should give. Hope you are able to get it. Okay, like I think it is. These are main, others are easy only. These are the most difficult things. Evaluate, examine, discuss. These are the most difficult things. Okay. I've written tough. Tough. Okay, analyze, critically discuss. Okay, critically examine. E critic. What do you think is this critically analyze? Now I'll ask you, like there are two students or some, you have written mains also. What is the meaning critically analyze? Is it different from discuss? If at all it is discuss, different from discuss, how is it different? Critically analyze means you will criticize the question. That is what is he asking? Or is there something else he's asking? I want your reaction, your logic. Aim ayyundachu, critically analyze. What do you think would be the logic, critically analyze?
In an editorial manner.
In an editorial manner, okay.
Negative,
positive should be there, then discuss, then how is it different? More of criticism. What we should criticize then? Huh? Which you don't like? Huh? Negative. No. Uh-huh. Okay, I will tell you. See, critically analyze means not criticizing the question. For example, see, inflation targeting is always good for Indian economy. Critically analyze. Suppose, let's take this question. That means RBI taking only inflation, okay? Or any other question. Or it is something like, RTI implementation in India, or RTI has brought in something like accountability, transparency, etc. Critically analyze. Both questions are there, one from economy, another from polity. Both are critically analyzed. What does that critically analyze mean? It is not criticizing RTI. It is not criticizing RTI. Remember, I'm not going to criticize the question. Whatever I write, I will be a self-critic of whatever I am writing. Suppose I'm writing a positive statement. I will say, for example, inflation targeting is good. Inflation targeting is good for the country. Okay, why? Because inflation will affect value of money. Okay, and India is always in problems related to something like inflation. Okay, this is a statement. Who made it? Who made the statement? I made this statement. What is critically analyze? I have to be a critic of the statement I made. I have to be a critic of the statement I made. That means what? For example, second statement will be, RBI can only handle inflation related to manufacturing. RBI cannot handle agriculture related inflation because there can be drought, there can be famine, there can be external situations, etc. That means what I'm saying, inflation targeting, who does? It's basically RBI. Okay, so inflation targeting, that means what did I do in the second statement? In the second statement, I've contradicted my first statement. I have become a critic of my own statement. Adi positive avachu, negative avachu. You are writing a positive about RTI, Okay, so I've written a dimension which is very much positive. RTI has brought in lot of accountability and government offices started performing. Many poor people or rural people do not know how to file RTI. Means what did I do? I have criticized the positive statement which I have written. I have become a critic of my answer or the statement which I have written. And subsequent statements also I do that. That is critically analyzed. It is not criticizing the institution or not criticizing the question. Ardhamainda. Got it, I believe. And this is the most difficult. Why it is difficult? Not difficult in the sense like you should have in and out. Suppose if I have to write 4 points for RTI, I should have some knowledge about RTI, okay, and I should be in a position of criticizing my own. Are you able to follow? Okay, so critically analyze or critically discuss or all this critically, ante question ni criticize cheyadamo, institution ni criticize cheyadam kaadu. It is something like you are criticizing whatever you have written in the subsequent paragraph. You have written up, or for example, inflation. RBI takes into consideration CPI now for determining inflation. Okay. And in CPI, you have only mainly oil and food. And oil and food are not in RBI's control. They are external factors. So how can RBI control by taking, that means what? RBI is taking some factor for monetary policy which is beyond RBI's control. And oil, food will determine CPI inflation. And oil and food are imports. So what will RBI do? So I'm contradicting my statement. Okay, or you can say, but positive thing is what? Oil and food are something really affecting our inflation. Therefore, oil and food have to be considered. Identi, I am reversing the statement. Ardhamainda. So, nenu rasina statement ne nenu criticize chestanu. Inko point rastanu positive, inkoti I will come up with criticizing it. I will go ahead in that manner. I am going to be a critic. Got it? Okay, now meetha simple. In the recent past, India-Pakistan relations have become cold, or India-Pakistan or China-India trade relations, etc. Or 2016 year was a very bad year for India-China relations. Explain. It can be discussed. Okay, so you will explain the area, Doklam, Giklam, all that. Okay, so you will go and explain it. It is nothing, there is much of difficulty is not there here. There is no much difficulty, explain. Easy kardamaipoddi. That means the topic I will explain. If it is enumerate will be when there is facts. Enumerate is when I will write only points, more of points at least, not paragraphs, more of points. Is that okay? Okay. Substantiate is something like you should have some examples. Okay, substantiate is at least you should have some. If you don't have examples also, no problem. Facts also can substantiate things. Examples can also substantiate things. And substantiate, explain, enumerate are easy, not that difficult. Okay, critically analyze. So when we are reading current affairs, okay, as we form links with respect to concepts, when you are reading about RTI, if there is a question on RTI, critically analyze. If there is a question on inflation related aspect, critically analyze. Ante nen em points rastano. So I said more of thinking, less of reading. Why more of thinking is when you brainstorm or two or three friends sit together and brainstorm it, probably you will get more better points. Okay, so that is something which is very important. Inka avale. I will write answers only after my preparation. My handwriting is bad. Okay, so I'll write answers only after my preparation. This is a fantastic idea. Kakapote, this is a useless idea. See, I take stand. No, I've taken stand. Why? Because you, in GS, there is nothing like syllabus. Fasal Bhima Yojana, syllabus lo unda. Edo scheme adi. Vachindi. Smart city. Current affairs nunchi vastadan telsa teliyadu. Are you able to follow? That means what? Do you know? That means somebody has read one by one all the topics, made notes of all the topics in syllabus. That means if you give the question paper, is the question paper reflecting what you have read in the syllabus directly? No. When there is no direct correlation, then what is your logic like? I will complete coaching and only then I will write answers. No institute can teach GS completely. If they are promising also, it is not easy. It is impossible. GS, how can you teach? Which area you will complete? Which area will complete completely? But yes, of course, a broader perspective can be given with respect to every subject. Understood? No. So that is something very important. Now, this is a previous UPSC question. And this is an ethics question. Okay. And this is a previous UPSC question. Is it visible? Chadodan kan avutunda? Okay. So I just want to see how much of your ethics knowledge. You said, no, we require knowledge. What knowledge is required for this? What I feel is practical application is more important. See, you're going to your UPSC interview. This was a question, I think, this year case study. You're going to the UPSC interview and you find that your relative has met with an accident. Okay, so what will you do? Something like this, the case study was. Okay, inner feeling would be, vidi ippude idiki accident avvala. Nenu 6 ela tarvata interview kelthunte vidiki ippude accident ayindi, vidi pothe baagundu. Okay, that is inner feeling. Why? Because it is heck of a moment. You are already 30 plus and you have gone already like after 6 attempts, after 5 mains you are going to the interview. Idi eppudo gaani raadu, vachindi. And this is your last opportunity and you have to go in 45 minutes. You hardly have 30 minutes. And now one more thing, he said it is in Delhi. One is Delhi. Why Delhi is important is whether hospitals are around, whether friends or relatives are around. So there's a logic, no? We develop some logic, no? And we will not write, though our inner feeling is that I will leave this fellow, I will move away, I'll go to interview. Though 95% of us will do that. Mari close relative, mana brother or sister or aithe tappite, aalochana undadu. Probably he'll say, we'll chudakapothe bound. You run. Why? Because it is your life and death. You feel no UPSC, no life. Okay, but then how should I project my answer? I will project my answer. I am ethical. Ante em jarugutund akkada? You are completely good or you have to show that you are clean hearted. Showing that you are clean hearted is easy. Clean heart develop jalante, there are something like environmental genetic factors, etc., etc. But showing that you are good is something easy. So which you should develop and some logic like idi raaste vadiki ekku marks vastaya, edi raaste better ethical, edi practical, getting it right. So you can't be completely illogical again. Okay, and say, why did I say I place this question after only if I complete my syllabus? So nobody knows ethics, suppose, here. Written mains here. Okay, so nobody knows what ethics is, that there is a paper on ethics, that is what you know. Okay, and still, suppose there is this case study, and I want your, I want you to come up with some points with respect to this case study. Those who are freshers on one side, those people who have studied already ethics on the other side. I'll leave you another 10 minutes, ante. Okay, so this is the case study. I'll read the case study. One of the scientists working in R&D laboratory of a major pharma company discovers that one of company's best-selling veterinary drugs, B, has the potential to cure a currently incurable liver disease that is prevalent in tribal areas. However, developing a variant of the drug suitable for human beings entailed a lot of research and development, having a huge expenditure to the extent of rupees 50 crore. It was unlikely that the company would recover the costs as the disease was rampant only in poor stricken area. It will not recover the costs because this is in a poor area, having very little market otherwise. There is no market. Okay. If you were the CEO, then identify the various actions that you could take. Evaluate the pros and cons of each of your actions. This is not our question. This is previous UPSC question. Now for thinking about this question, is prior ethics knowledge, thinker's knowledge. See, question paper is practical ethics, not theoretical ethics. Lexicon book will give you some, what you call, it is something like it gives you some, keywords. Or Subbarao ankonte inkoti. Okay, there is that book also. These are the two books which people read. Okay, but that is theoretical ethics. No, but the exam is all about practical ethics. It is more of application, except for a few questions, which we anyhow, like Gandhi's sins, there are some things which you have to read, but rest is more of application. Are you able to follow? Okay, so for this, what will be the approach means, oh, I've read Subbarao book or lexicon, I will get great ideas for this case study, means I will not accept. So this is a case study which is simple. Accident ayindi nu em chestavante daniki nen lexicon javutene answer chesta. No, but what will lexicon do? Revise lexicon, pull out 150 keywords, make a synopsis, wherever possible I will push, so that my answers look like ethical answers, or my subject is ethics. No, it should look like ethics. It should not look like polity, it should not look like geography. Obviously it should look like ethics. So for which I require some keywords, bunch of words. In the time span I have to push it. And some diagrams, legal, illegal, ethical, unethical. Okay, so these things you should be. Now for this, now what do you think would be some of the solutions? One is visible there. One visible item where, first one I've pushed there. Taking support of government. Because as a CEO, I have to do my duty well. Okay, that means I have to look after the profits of the company also. I cannot take action, because that is also important for me. Okay, so therefore, support of government is one. Okay, raising money through equity market. Ante id ethics ante kaadu. It is something like company can issue shares, etc., and raise money. That is also an option that is which I'm talking about. One option. Okay, or collaborating with foreign company. Okay, we'll explain things to foreign company, but foreign company without profits, will it collaborate, etc.? We don't know. Okay, you go and explain it to Melinda Gates Foundation, madam. Okay, so you are kind-hearted, so do something, etc. Okay, so they might collaborate, do something, because it is related to welfare. Okay. Appealing common people through media and NGOs for collaboration and funds through sale of products. This is also, it will take a lot of time. This also will take a lot of time. It is not that easy. Okay, from every product you buy, okay, it will go, there was like shampoo ads. Okay, so you buy 10 rupees item, 2 rupees will go, or you save a child, etc., motivate people, get it. Getting it is very difficult. It will take some time. Okay, so, and now, question enti, manaki oka 3-4 ideas untai. Okati public-private partnership avachu. One would be something like foreign company collaboration. Another is equity market. Another is straight asking the government to help us. Okay, I don't have other option. I can't say, let my company go to hell. I will say that this will lead to profits. Means, you should not write that. You may be good to the society. You are bad to the company where you are working, which is bad. It is unethical. Are you following? Why? Because what is your personal interest to help poor people? It's your personal interest. But there is an organizational interest here, which is getting into conflict with your personal interest. An organizational interest has to be taken care of, because you are, that is the company which is giving you food. And therefore that point, as I have not, an option. Hope you are able to follow. Private company unte enta lekapothe enta. Okay, so I'll help people. That we will not write. That is what I'm trying to tell you. Okay, so now here, for each one, you will come up with merits and demerits. Okay, so merits, it will solve the funding issue. Poor people will benefit. Justice will be done to them. Government machinery can be utilized for better service delivery. Okay, demerits, it will put subsidy burden on government. You're able to follow, I believe. Simple only. Company ownership of the product will be diluted. Okay, raising money through equity market. Okay, so if that is the thing, it will solve the problem temporarily. Equity market, again, equity market, if you want to raise money from the market, shareholders should feel that you will make profits. Only then you can raise money. Understood? No, otherwise no. Okay, so poor people will benefit. Corporate social responsibility will be fulfilled. But if you are going to explain, okay, for you that is corporate social responsibility, as part of corporate social responsibility. Demerit, investors may lose money in future because you will not get revenues. Many companies might come under severe financial stress. Assumption. Okay, they have pushed money into this, so companies might come into financial stress. Okay. That in the sense, like, it is something like, if equity is not just purchased by individuals, it can be purchased by some firms also. Okay, then collaborating with foreign merits, not just poor of India, but of whole world will benefit. Okay, why? Because a foreign company will give it somewhere also. Okay, two, the problem can be solved in holistic manner. Okay, edo trial kada, merits, demerits. Okay, demerits, issues of intellectual property rights may hamper this collaboration. Okay, so new product, no, patents and all issues. Foreign company may sell the drug at higher prices if it is patented, etc. So there can be some, you can write anything else also. Okay, so you can push in anything else also. But I feel, okay, 1-2 points, if you write, your 200, 250 will be over. Okay, appealing common people through media and NGOs for collaboration and funds through sale of properties. Pool of social activities, there's some grammar mistakes. Good publicity of company will be done. Increase in sales and profits, which then are transferred to the project. Okay, demerits may also decrease the sale as price of company's products will be increased. May take a long time to collect necessary funds, etc. Okay, so here, what I want to tell you is, this is just an example to tell you, like, how much of lexicon book will be of help for analyzing such case studies? Are you able to understand? So lexicon, Subba Rao, so avanni aipothe ala gaadu, first question papers theeyali. We have to pull out our question papers, see what they are asking, whether it is theoretical or application, and go accordingly. If it is application part, what should I do? Is there any other book? Okay, there are some books like Ethics for Everyday Life. It's a general story book. Philosophy for Everyday Life. Leadership for Everyday Life. These are some regular books. These books will look more apt. Okay, rather than lexicon. And lexicon chadavaddante coaching materials are also made from lexicon and Subba Rao only. So obviously you will read one material, their knowledge, their content is already pushed in. So it is all about how you think. Okay, for example, I will talk about, like, we have talked about different keywords earlier sessions for those people. For each keyword, you have to come up with some examples from the modern context. So for example, Ajit Doval can be given as an example for, in ethics, Ajit Doval can be given as an example for fearless attitude. Okay, you can think of examples like that. Okay, or if you see, there was a person called as U. Sagayan, IAS officer. Okay, and he was the first person to disclose his assets. Okay, so when we are talking about honesty, when you are talking about integrity, it is not always you will write Gandhi and Mother Teresa. In Gandhi, daati raara. Gandhi, Mother Teresa, kakunda, varied examples, Rayal Gada. We have to write something more than Gandhi. And Sridharan is an example which we have written 4 years back, 5 years back, 5.5 years back, or 2012, 13 time. Now, same Sridharan for integrity. What is fortitude? Meaning? English? Fortitude. Undaiman word, fortitude. Ain't the fortitude ante? What is fortitude? Standing by courage. Yeah. Can you Reshma Qureshi? As a victim. Okay. Who walked the New York? Reshma Qureshi. Fortitude. Coming back. Malala Yousafzai. Fortitude. Not giving up. Ante gaani, pratidaniki Gandhi Bosu, inka ante gaadu. You have to write varied example which others are not writing. So for which way you will get, you should think. You should think for bringing difference in your answer. See, for example, of course, what we did was Mahabharata Ramayana Jadvi, we made notes. Okay, and for everything you write Mahabharata Ramayana also, it is boring. Okay, so bad friendship anagane malli Duryodhana Karna. Okay, so we write, that means we are inclined to write what we have learnt only, rather than thinking beyond that. Okay, so I've given this example. See, there are two friends. No, I said Raja Ratnam was one, and there was one more person. Raja Ratnam is a Sri Lankan person. And there was one more, his name I am unable to recall, insider trading. He was arrested for insider trading. Rajat Gupta. No, Rajat Gupta. Okay, Dean of ISB. He used to come to our B school also. Okay, so that Rajat Gupta and Raja Ratnam friendship, insider trading. When Rajat Gupta used to come to our campus, we used to look at him in awe. I told him like, you know, oh, this person is very intelligent. Everything used to put it with integrals and differentiation. He's so very intelligent. And you suddenly find something in the newspaper, okay, that this fellow is arrested for insider trading. You feel bad. Okay, or greed destroys breed, or bad friendship creates problems. Why don't we think beyond Duryodhana and Karna? Are you able to follow? Okay. Or there is something like corporate mismanagement or something like here. See, greed destroys breed, subprime crisis. The economy. Though you know they are not right borrowers, you have come up with lending money which has led to a crisis called a subprime crisis, creating problems for next few years. Why don't we think beyond? Or there are something like out of the box thinking. I gave this example many times. I like this IAS officer, Armstrong Pammy. Okay, so that means what? If you follow unconventional methods, you are going to go against the government. Is wrong. That means unconventional method is this person has raised money from Facebook to build a 100-kilometer road in Manipur. Only that no money was taken from government. So out of the box thinking ante Armstrong Pammy. So meeku ardhamaindi anukunta. This is not there in book. You have bureaucracy example. This is a clear bureaucracy example which we can write. Understood? No. So for each are you following? So we should have an example in mind. Or in quote, competition instigates the habit of cheating. Something like that. Competition, over competition will instigate the habit of cheating. Okay. So can you give some examples? IPS officer case, Vyapam scam, Telangana medical paper leak. Patent issues between Apple and Samsung, okay, or Volkswagen pollution issues. So where are we getting these from? It is not lexicon. Start thinking. It is again from newspaper only. It is again from newspaper. Where are these? They are there in newspaper. Is that clear? Understood? Okay. So this is about the answer writing session. So what I thought, I should have, you are already tired. I thought of explaining our program also. Okay, so our program is not basically, I'll just take 5 minutes. It's not basically a test series. It's not a test series. What is a test series? So we give you 20 questions. Next day there would be explanation. It is not test series. So from the beginning, last 2 years, we were never conducted test series. For prelim also, we came up with a model called as test discussion series for the first time. Okay, where we used to give 200 questions every day, the next day we used to discuss. That day 200 questions, next day discuss. So through those questions, we used to address the concepts of polity, geography, history, economy. On each subject, we used to solve 1500 questions. So 7500 questions approximately for 75 days, through which we used to revise our syllabus at a faster pace. This was our idea. So that was the prelims test discussion series. Again, that was not test series because you'll have teacher every day taking four and a half hour class. That will start in March, and those people who are enrolling for this would be opted for that. Initially, I don't know, but it was mains ante. Mains will come only, yes, you will write answers, and prelims has become very dicey, and especially because it's evaluating only on GS. Okay, so that course which we generally start on March 1st, so that will also be included. So that is the course. I thought I'll show you books, but your faces look bits and all, what are the questions like, how do we do, but right now mokal chuste naaku ardham ayipindi. And our program is this, mains program is basically into three segments. we do it on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And we have classes from 2 to 6 o'clock. Initially, when you come down, 1 hour you will write. Okay, 1 hour you will write. And most of you have enrolled also already. So the topics would be for the next few. Tomorrow also there's a workshop on answer writing. I'll do some practical aspects related to answer. That means we'll give you one sheets. We'll brainstorm some answers tomorrow. Okay, so that is what we are going to do in tomorrow's workshop. And it is also like an open session. Okay, so, and some, most of you have registered. So these people like Tuesdays and Thursdays, 2 to 3, 1, have exam. That is exam in the sense, initially we'll make you write only 3 questions or 4 questions. We are not going to dump 10 or 15. So that is the difference between a regular, what you call a test series and this incremental approach which we are doing. So incrementally, we'll try to increase your answer writing. And pure main subjects which are there, no? For example, ethics is there, essay is there, internal security, IR, and we also have world history, Indian society, okay, and disaster management, etc., for which we'll have separate classes. And after the classes, we'll have, that is after your exam, no? We'll have a small discussion on the previous questions. The 3-4 questions you have done, no, that we will discuss after your writing practice. That would be 30 minutes. And then subsequently, you will have a class. And what would be the class? Class would be pure main areas. We will start off with class discussion. Something that is there in prelims and mains. For example, we have modern history is there, Indian geography, Indian constitution, which is there in prelims and mains. These separate mains classes will not be there. For these, we are going to address only through questions. For example, for those people who have joined, we have Tuesday, you'll write like modern history and current affairs. 1857 to 1905 would be the syllabus. So I'll ask you to write, read spectrum. If you want, you can read anything. You can read senior sir notes, or you can read anything else, which is comfortable for you. But I will give 2 questions on modern history and 2 questions will be on current. What is current? That 10, basically. Now, initially. 1 month, no. Initially, it would be an incremental writing answer practice. And these 4 questions we will discuss on Thursday. I'll give you the sheets on Thursday, we'll discuss. And the class would be different. Now ethics after, ethics or IR which we are discussing, after 15 days, you'll get some hold of ethics terms and how to do those. Ethics again comes back to you in the form of questions. Are you able to follow? That time it would be a second revision. So that is the program basically. So I am explaining ethics, you will not write ethics. When there is IR classes or governance classes, you will not write governance. You will be writing something else other than what is taught. There is a logic for that. You have to reflect on your own. Attitude jeppesi or case study jeppesi. On attitude, if I give a question, definitely you will write. That is not the point. So, and 2-3 subjects should be over at a time. And if you're reading, that will be helpful for prelims. That will be helpful for mains. And modern history is something everybody knows something about it. Initially, we'll start off with modern history for writing and current affairs. Current affairs is that 10 days, these 10 days, whatever is happening, no, that area will be taken. Now, then this program will go, this 2 days program, no, it will go on till Feb end. That is Feb end in the sense, it will go on till April, but on March 1st, you will be clubbed with our prelims test discussion batch. So that time we will have prelims ante chala vallandi bayam untadi. We'll have like the people keep joining for that test discussion. So there anyhow, we'll be discussing on each subject 1200 questions. At 1200 questions, aim untai. You will have all UPSC previous questions from 1990 and UPSC conducted exams, CDS, IES, NDA, because I felt repetition was possible. But last year there was a bouncer. I'm not telling that every time whatever you create, a model you create will definitely be successful. No, but yes, if you practice 7,500 questions, guessing capabilities will increase. That is the logic. And we should not prepare for old question paper. That is, before last year, current affairs ichar gavati, only vision books teeskon current affairs jadvesi vere vadilesi. Last time, no culture was there on modern history, you'll read medieval India came up. So it's not that. You're not preparing for the next paper. You're basically preparing for the previous paper. So it is not preparing for the previous paper. No, previous paper was factual and current affair. Everybody read current affairs. Last year paper was different. Polity, Lakshmikant saripoledu. 23 questions were there on polity. It was little more conceptual. That means what? Don't prepare for previous paper. I tell you, mains, people who have written mains had a better chance of clearing those polity questions. Writing, that is, marking those polity questions because they have a wider, are you able to follow what that? And I don't know the next, like Like the last year, some conceptual questions will be there, like polity, etc., in some other subject. We do not know. Are you following? So don't be ready for any kind of paper or uncertainty when we are aspiring for the best job. That is the only suggestion I can give you. When you want to get into the best job in the country or the best service in the country, so there's very minimum chance which you can take. I'll prepare only this, I'll prepare only that, I'll prepare only facts, I'll not prepare concepts. No. If polity is there, any question that comes in, I will do it. That should be the response. And for that prelim, you people will also be made to, we will be attending that prelims test discussion program. And that program will be from 9:30 to 1:30. So from March 1st till April 10th, will be a little rigorous. Why? Because the prelims pay will be from 9:30 to 1:30, and Tuesday and Thursday, this is same, Tuesday and Thursday, 2 to 6, you will be writing answers and etc. And I don't think 2 days is a problem. Why? Because rest of the 4 days, you can give it for your optional. Are you getting what I'm trying to tell you? So that is why 2 days. So 2 days only you will write. So, and you'll not prepare for only this 2 days writing practice. You should do your optional. You will read superficially everything and you will try apply your brain and write. Ah, idu test undi kaabatti only modern history chaduta. Aa chadivi Tuesday, Thursday vasta. No, that is the wrong strategy. You set some time for reading for these 3 questions. The rest of the time should be utilized appropriately. GSI will help you. Optional you should take care. Understood? No. So that is the basic logic here. So, and there are many freshers also, and that is the reason we said mains areas we'll have classes. And classes also will not be like what is attitude, etc. It will be something like whatever we are discussing, we'll put UPSC questions on board and we'll discuss the concept and we'll discuss the question related to it. So we'll hit the basic also, but it will not be pure basic. Pure basic ante, but what is attitude, lexicon lo undi, ade malli, notes ichi. So it will not be that format. So I have to be very clear. So I should be very clear, like what would be the approach. So attitude, I'll explain. Okay, take notes for attitude. No. Examples related to innovative, examples related to keywords, I'll give notes. Or I'll give synopsis or a printed copy. But attitude definition anni dictate chestana ante cheyanu. I'm crystal clear with respect to what I'm trying to do. Okay. And I will not conduct tests on the topic which the teacher teaches. That also I'm very clear. And with respect to that, I'm not open to suggestions also, because what I feel is you should reflect without reading anything. Okay, but this is a fresher and repeater kind of batch. Therefore, we'll give you a regular syllabus. That is the thing which we do. Okay, now this will happen till this mains program. I will stop by April 10th because you have to prepare for prelims vigorously. Okay, so 2 days till April. And May 10th, we'll stop that prelims program. May 5th or May 10th, we'll stop the prelims program. That time you can revise. After 21 days after your prelims, whether you write it well or not, you will assemble back. Okay, that is the logic. And we generally run that 30-member batch. We used to run 2 programs. One is a test discussion and a 30-member core mains batch, where already those people who had already gone, already in service like IRTS, IPS, etc., who want to improve their service, or already veterans who have written 3-4 mains. And we used to make like weekly 3 days, we used to make them write 10 to 15 questions or 7 to 8, 7 to 10, 10 to 15 questions, vigorous answer writing. So what we do is after this April training, you will be pushed into that batch. So it's not that they are very great, we are pushed into that batch and the cinema ledu, evadu great gaadu, vallakante meer better raayachu kuda. So it's not like that those people want, like we will write only answers. And that we had weekly 3 days. And they used to write, and the class would be on a different thing. They are writing modern history, class was on polity. Okay, so they are writing ethics, class would be something else. And we were like simultaneous elections, so even we discussed JSM last time. And it is all about luck that questions come up in the exam. Okay, so that means current affairs, that means current affairs, or these things all will be discussed. So this, that means you will be clubbed into that batch where you will be touching till next mains, that is till next mains. You will be writing answers. Understood? No. And one more thing. We'll only come for classes. Please don't come. Okay. So that is not, that means it is something like writing practice session. And that is what I have mentioned in the ad. I stick to what I write. So writing practice ante writing practice kosam raval. Class untadi. kani class class kosame ante I don't think that will add value to your preparation. Okay, it is only writing writing practice is more important than class. Andar jadu adhe spectrum. Understood, I think. Okay, I'm very clear. You write, you think more. Okay, and we'll get to know our mistakes. Others who write beautiful answers, we will put it on board. Okay, so there will be value addition. One person can't think as far as GS is concerned. Okay, so many thoughts, definitely yes. And classes will be conducted, classes different faculty will teach. Answer writing only I will take. Okay, subjects I will take, but answer writing though no other faculty will be given. So that also I'll be very clear. So answer writing only I will be taking. Okay, so classes wise, yes, world history, you have another faculty coming in, some governance issues, another faculty coming in. But for governance answer discussion, no. Okay, why? Because I want like flowchart and point format, or I want them to stick to the question. If they're doing that, it's fine. Okay, so this would be our, this thing. Will I give model answers? I will not give model answers. I will put it on board. Model answers initially I can't provide because my resources do not allow me. You should be having somebody who will type things well and create a model answer. And model answer may not be always okay. But yes, as time progresses, as we have uploaded in Facebook, no. So similarly, I'll give you a copy of those. And that doesn't mean you'll not make notes with respect to whatever is pushed on the board. And one more thing is, we have started some recording and all. So recording some videos, answer writing, we will, if you are at all absent, we will give you. But there may be some faculty who do not want things to be recorded, so that time I can't help. Got it. So that is also crystal clear. My class, yes. Okay, so not an issue. Okay, answer writing, discussion, yes. Any doubts, personal attention from any faculty, yes. That we will do. Okay, so these are the things which we are going to focus on. Okay, so it is all about combined effort, and it is expected that you will also write answers. And whatever key I give may not be the best answer. Relatively, I will see that more points are included. That doesn't mean, yes, that is the best answer. No, in GS, there's nothing like, oh, this is the great answer. No, I might feel it is a very good answer, probably. You might feel no there. But we will see to that, oh, if this is the question, these are the dimensions should be addressed. So these are the points that should be there. So this is what, and it is all about your practice and your effort. Program. So three parts of the program. One is, initially you will write like slowly and the class is going on. So that you will not have, and that also only 2 days only we will do. Okay, and from March, that test discussion, again it is not test series. Every day, and you can solve the questions. You take the 2 sheets, you solve 200 bits, you come to the next class. You take 200 bits, you solve, come to the next class, which you will not do. I know. Cheyaleru. Andike test series discussion anle. Test discussion series. Ante discuss chestam. Meer test rasina rayakapoyina ani. That is the meaning. Meaning is that. So test discussion series is, we'll give you paper, you'll read president from Lakshmikant, come and sit. Faculty will discuss about president. So other perspectives about president, because this person has knowledge about politics since last 3-4 years, you will widen the your perspective, or more areas will be covered. Bit related areas, cheptam kada, four options you will explain. So knowledge will increase. And guessing capacity, main, what is the maksat, what is the main aim of your prelims program, means to guess properly. You ask me one word, to guess properly. If A and B are eliminated, I have to guess from C and D, then through practice, yes. If I mark 10, I will mark 6 right. So for that, what is required? Practice. That is the program. Okay, I think it is clear. Okay, and that 30 member batch is already there. That will be there. That would be after prelims. Okay, that prelims test discussion batch will be there. That would be from March. And this is a batch which is a different batch, which is a long term kind of batch. Got it right? That's it. I'll